To our all bands concert for 2024-25 school year. Very excited to share a lot of really great music with you guys. All of our students have been working really hard for these last couple months, and nobody's worked harder than our fifth graders on stage. They started playing in September, and we've only seen them once, maybe twice a week, and they have learned a lot in that short amount of time. So all of these students are beginners on their instruments. We have a fantastic piece to share with you today, and it is called Hot Cross Beats.
Thank you.
myself. My name is Dr. Kelly Nivison, for those of you that are new to our school or new to our program. I am one of the two band directors here at Ravenscroft. We're privileged to have two. I have a woodwind focus. Mr. Paranak has a brass focus. I will be conducting all the pieces for sixth grade tonight. We have our sixth grade band on stage. Now, out of this group, we have quite a few beginners who just started this year. So, can I have my beginners that have never played an instrument before? Can you stand, please? All right, they had a lot of ground to gain because our veterans already had a year of playing under their belt, and so they started sixth grade band pretty much running. So we have two great pieces for you tonight. We have Miramar Fanfare, which is our fast march style piece, and we will end with Midnight Sky, which is a lovely chorale style, and we are all gonna play in our three rules of chorale playing, right, sixth grade? Yeah, all right. So I hope y'all enjoy.
Thank you. Good evening, thank you all for being here. With the all bands concert, we have four different ensembles and lots of equipment and lots of people, and we're trying to coordinate everything. So it looks a little hectic, but we're making it happen. Behind me is the 7th and 8th grade band. Many of these students have played at least 1 year. Some have played maybe 3 years, and we have a wonderful time. First, we'd like to thank Fine Arts Association, President Tiffany Brooks, and all that the association does on a daily basis. There are refreshments following the performance, the program, everything. If you would like to help out, you are automatically in the association. You can contact her or go to the Veracross portal, the parent portal, and you can find more information there. Also, check out the weekly emails that Ravenscroft sends out. There's information in that as well. If it's simple as contributing to the reception or helping with the upcoming chamber concert or helping with events like this, I'm sure they would appreciate your help. So thank you to all of them that do that. Thank you, ushers, and everybody that helps put on this event. Thank you, Dr. McChesney, for helping with the live stream. Also, thank you to Mr. Sharp. We were riding lifts yesterday, getting lights set and getting things set up for you tonight. So we hope tonight will be a really enjoyable evening. We have a lot more planned. I think I've stalled long enough. The first piece for middle school band is a wonderful march in the style of the season, with Halloween being tomorrow, and Dia de los Muertos, November 1st and 2nd. This is called March Diabolique. Features lots of chromaticism, lots of moods, lots of moody sounds and themes. So we hope you enjoy March Diabolique.
Thank you.
Our next composition won the Frank Tichelli Composition Award for Beginning Band. The piece is written actually for beginners, and she intentionally wrote it to not sound like any other middle school or beginning band piece. I said, perfect, let's do it. This creates a mood and an experience with improvisation, and it's not jazz, but it's students choosing when they play at certain times and how fast or how slow or how loud or how soft they play, and creating an ambiance and a vibe and a feel. Jody Blackshaw is an excellent New Zealand composer, written lots of works from beginning band all the way up to collegiate level, professional level, and ensemble music. So it features a lot of unique sounds, and we're going to try to morph one sound into the other, and we'll see if we can create some magic and create a little bit of mood and stillness. So we hope you enjoy Whirlwind.
Thank you.
that's one of those pieces that for like the first 4 weeks, they're like, why are we playing this? This is terrible. I don't know what's happening. It sounds awful. What are we doing? And then last week, they're like, ah, we get it. Yes, that's right. So it never is the same way twice. If we were to perform it again, it would be a different interpretation. I enjoy doing pieces like that. Our final piece is called Derivations. It's kind of the same two or three motifs that the composer moves around, speeds up, slows down, moves around to different voices of the instrument. Following middle school, we'll have about a 3 to 4 minute set change to get upper school in and get kind of them ready and settled. So we'll ask for a little patience there. But this is Derivations.
Thank you.
This is the upper school wind ensemble, comprised of 9th through 12th graders. This is the band in high school. There's no top band and bottom band in high school, like a lot of high school programs have. This is it. So if you're a 9th grader, all the way up through senior year, we're in the same ensemble. So the level of performance, the standard is very high. We challenge them a lot. So we're apologizing for all the notes, too many notes for them to play. But we love doing it. They love the challenge. And so we got some exciting pieces prepared for you this evening. The first one is an American classic by Morton Gould called American Salute. One afternoon, the radio station said, we need a piece for this radio program the following evening. Mr. Gould, would you write something? He wrote it, stayed up till 2 a.m. The parts were written, handwritten, by 8 a.m. in time for rehearsal, and then it was live on the air that evening. So I wouldn't say procrastination pays off, but this is a really cool example of I have to create something. It's a classic of American music. The common theme is the ants go marching one by one. So if you want to keep up and count how many times you hear that, I'd be interested to hear what the total is. But every section gets something cool to play. You hear it at the 4th of July, you'll hear it at lots of festivals and events. So we hope you enjoy American Salute.
Thank you.
All right, so as you can already see, there is a big jump in ability level and music that we give our kiddos from each band to the next. There's a huge jump from fifth grade to sixth grade music. There's a huge jump from sixth grade to middle school music. And there's a really big jump from middle school to upper school music. So we ask a lot of our students, we give them some really challenging literature, but we do it because they always rise to the occasion. And they always become amazing musicians because of this. So our next piece is called Amaranthus. This work commemorates the 70th birthday of Mr. Kikuo Atarashi, who is the former conductor of the Teneri High School Wind Orchestra in Japan. The composer writes here, he said, "With gratitude, I composed a chorale themed around amaranth, which is a flower, which carries the floral meaning of immortality and undying, hoping it will be widely embraced in concerts as material to nurture a love for music."
Thank you.
All right, our next piece is Dance Macabre. This is originally a symphonic poem for orchestra written in 1874 by French composer Camille Saint-Saëns. The arrangement today was arranged for full band, but it remains very faithful to the original version. A little bit about it. According to legend, death appears at midnight every year on Halloween. Death calls forth the dead from their graves to dance for him while he plays his fiddle, which here is going to be represented by the alto saxophone section. His skeletons dance for him until the rooster crows at dawn, when they must return to their graves until the next year. The piece opens with the harp and the chimes playing a single note, D, 12 times, to signify the stroke of midnight. It's also accompanied by soft chords in the clarinet section. The saxophones enter, playing a tritone, which was known at the time as the Diabolus in Musica, or the Devil in Music. Just the interval itself was the Devil in Music. Then there is an abrupt break toward the end of the piece. The texture changes, and it represents the dawn breaking and the skeletons returning to their graves. So behind our setup tonight, you're going to see a display projected onto our back partitions there. This is an animation of the story of the Dance Macabre that was aired on PBS in the 1980s. And it's a really great illustration of the story that we hope adds to our performance of the piece tonight.
Thank you.
written by Mr. Mark Hin- Dr. Mark Hensley, I'm sure, at the University of Illinois. It's in the program, I said it, check. Okay, good. Illinois made it in the program. Dr. McChesney walks in and goes, "Mark Hensley, love that guy." And had a 20-minute story about him going to the post office. So that is legitimate, high-level concert band music, and they did an exceptional job. I think they should get another round. Again, thank you all for being here. There will be a reception to follow in the lobby. Thank you, Fire Arts Association, and all the faculty here on campus. This is what Dr. Knives and I get to do every day. It's both exhilarating and exciting and frustrating and annoying and awesome and exciting. It changes like every 30 seconds. But we get to make music with these wonderful students of yours. Thank you for letting them do this. It's not easy, but it's definitely worth it. Since we have the projection, we're going to do one more piece for you. This was written by the Dutch composer Johan de May, and it's entitled Aquarium. But first, we need to introduce you to the cast of characters. So as they swim by, you'll be able to recognize them in the music. So we have three movements. We'll move quickly from movement to movement, so it won't be much break. In the first movement, we have the Neon Tetra. First movement, we have the electric eel, which is represented by a pulsing percussion groove in the timpani and tom. Finally, in the first movement, we have the angelfish, which is represented by a cluster of chords in the brass and woodwinds. They're using a lot of different mutes. We have straight mutes, cut mutes, harmon mutes to create this really magical effect. And so here's that sound. Movement two becomes a little more ominous. There's a battle between the seahorse and a couple of other friends. The seahorse theme starts in the Barry sax, and it sounds like this. Been a really good way to make sure they can practice their melodies in front of a live audience. The seahorse gets in a battle with the zebrafish, or sometimes called the red lionfish, and it's a series of ominous chords that are really, really kind of cool. Here we go. That movement, the seahorse or red lion, or the zebra horse or the red lionfish, and the seahorse and the neon tetra in minor, listen for that, all kind of have a spirited a dialogue. In the third movement, we are introduced to the guppy, which first begins in the piccolo and alto sax. Swims around and has a lovely time. So, this is Aquarium by Johan de Mee. Again, thank you so much for being here. We hope you enjoy. Thank you. seeing you. Thank you.